Hello, my name is Gyanesh, and today we are going to discuss about tables in NAVISION 2016. So tables are the fundamental objects in Microsoft Dynamics NAV objects. They store records which are collected through forms and pages. We can take examples like we have customers, sales, and inventories. And these records are then presented to the users through forms, pages, and requests. Let's see some fundamentals of tables. So a table can be visualized as a two-dimensional matrix which comprises of columns and rows. Here each row is a single record and each column is a field in that record. It also consists of table data and table description. The table data contains the actual records and their fields, while the table description specifies the layout and properties of the table and the labels. Now, a table generally consists of properties, where properties are related to the table and related to the fields. And of course, they are related to the keys inside that table. It also have triggers, which are predefined functions, which are executed when a certain event occurs. We have two types of triggers. One is table triggers. Another one is your field triggers. Apart from these triggers, we also have one more important term that is known as fields, where fields define the actual information which are kept in a table, and each field has its own properties and triggers. Every field in a table has an appropriate data type, and each data type is used to hold a specific kind of information. We can have examples like text data, numbered or numeric data, dates, and so on. And the last important thing is the keys. So the table description also contains a list of a key. A key is a sequence of one or more field IDs from the table. We can associate up to 40 keys in the table, and keys are used to define the sorting method of records in a table. So let's have a look at how we will be able to create a table and how we can check the properties of that tables. So let me take you to the NAVISION. We'll go to Tools, Object Designer. I will select Table as an object, and then I will click on New. So as you can see, it is showing me a field number, which is 1. Now I'm going to add a field name. So the field name is my EMP ID. I will take it in the integer format. The second column, which I'm going to define, is about employee name, which is of text type. By default, it contains 30 as in length, but you will be able to modify the length of the data type. And the third one is your EMP age, which is of integer type. Once you have created this table, let's click on this close button. Save, say yes. Now you need to give an ID to the table. So I'm going to give ID as 12356701, and I'm going to give it a name as an employee demo table. Now I will click on OK. And you can check your table inside the table list over here. As you can see, this is the table which I have just created over here. Now, if I will again take you to the design of this table, you can go to View and you can go to Keys. By default, employee ID is the primary key for this table, and we can use employee ID for our sorting purpose. Apart from that, we have triggers also. So for checking the triggers, you can click on the CIL code. And there you will find the list of triggers that are available in my table. So as you can see, we have right now I have on validate and on lookup. These all are my event functions or triggers. And so on, we can add some more triggers inside this application or in this table. Thank you so much for watching this video.